Okay, so now let's do this very interesting question, which is also on forces. The question reads, a box of mass 10 kg is pulled by an attached cord along a horizontal smooth or frictionless surface of a table. The force exerted is 40 Newton. So this is the force which was exerted on the object. And it was exerted, or it was applied at an angle of 30 degrees as shown. So now the question is to calculate the acceleration of the box, B, the magnitude of the upward normal force exerted by the table on the box. Okay, so to find this question, we're going to apply the concept of Newton's second law of motion. Okay, which brings into this formula, force is equal to mass times the acceleration. Okay, now let's try to write the free body diagram. Okay, we can write the free body diagram of which this is going to be the box, because the free body diagram should only show forces. So this is going to be the box, and this is the force which was applied. Okay, and this force was applied at an angle. So the angle is 30 degrees, and downward you need to know that there was a force which was acting on the object to bring it down, and this force is the weight force. Okay, but we need to know that when an object is resting on a surface, there is always an applied force with the surface applied on the block. And this force is actually which we call the normal force. Okay, so this normal force is going to go upwards. So this is actually what I'm saying. Okay, so this is going to be our box. This is the force. Okay, this is going to be the normal force. The weight force, this is our force, which is Fp in this case. Okay, now since this is the force was at an angle of 30 degrees, that means we are going to break it in two components. We are going to have Fpx, which is the x component, and Fpy, which is the y component. What you need to know is that the Fpy, the y component, is always Fp sine theta. And this is going to be now Fp, the force itself, multiplied by cosine theta. That's the x component. That's how we used to do when we were doing vectors. So now, having this information, we can find the acceleration of the box. Now, where are we going to apply the second law of motion is here. Okay? So Newton's second law of motion tells us to say that the object is going to move in the direction of the force. Okay? It's going to move in the direction of the force. So as you can see now, this force, this object is going to move because, as you can see in the question, you have been told to say that the cord has been attached along a horizontal smooth surface. So this object is going to move in the x direction. That means to say there is no force, there is no motion in the y direction. So that we can write to say that the summation of forces in the y direction is going to be equal to zero. Okay? But the summation of forces in the x direction is going to be equal to mass times acceleration. Now, as you can see, we have motion in the x direction. That means to say we are not going to use directly this force. We are going to use the x component to show the force which was applied in the x direction. So we are going to say to find this, because the first question is asking us to find the acceleration, that means to say the summation of forces in the x direction now is going to be equal to, because we need to find what? We need to find we need to find the acceleration. That means to say we're going to divide m everywhere. So the acceleration formula is going to be equal to now the x component of the force over mass. Okay, so now the x component of a force is given by this. Actually, this Fp cosine theta. Okay, over mass. What is our Fp? Is actually 40 newton. Cosine, the angle theta is 30 degrees over the mass, which is actually 10 kg. So the acceleration now is going to be, once you compute this on your calculator, you're going to get 3.46 meters per cubic meters per second square there. This is how you find the acceleration. So now, next thing is to find the magnitude of the upward force, which is the normal force, this force actually. So as you can see, this force is acting in the y direction, which is acting vertically. That means we are going to add all the forces which are acting in the vertical direction. And what you need to know is that since there is no force, there is no motion in the y direction. As you can see, the force that the object was moving in the x direction, that means in the y direction, the summation of forces must be equal to zero. So it's us now to identify the forces which acting in the y direction. As you can see, we have the same normal force. The other force, as you can see, this force now, Fpy, okay, the component, the vertical component of Fp, the applied force. We also have the weight force, which is acting downwards. So what you need to understand is that if the forces are acting upwards, like in the previous video, I was saying that if the force is acting upwards, the force is going to be positive. So this is going to be positive, even this one is going to be positive. But the weight force is acting downward, is going to be negative. So what we are going to do is for us now to say, in the y direction, we have the normal force plus the y component of the force minus the weight force, because the weight force is going downward, then is equal to zero, because we have no motion in the vertical direction. So what else can we do? We need to find the normal force. That means to say we're going to take this to the other side. We're going to remain with the normal force. It's going to be equal to the weight force. When it goes to the other side, it's going to be positive since it is negative, and this one is going to be negative. What is the weight force? The weight force is given by the weight is given by mass times acceleration due to gravity. So it's the case of us repressing now. So let me actually use this space. No space here. Okay, I'm going to use the same space. So the weight is going to be given by mass times gravitational acceleration due to gravity. Then this actor is the y component of this force, and it's going to be Fp sine theta. Fp sine theta. What is our mass? Okay, our mass is actually 10. So it is what we are going to do is actually we say mass times it. The gravitational force, we can let this to be 9.8 meters per second square there. Actually, that'll be a little space. Okay, but we're going to manage the space. So we're going to say the normal force is going to be mass times that mass is actually 10 multiplied by 9.8. Okay, then we subtract by the force. We are subtracting. The force is actually 40. Then sine 30. So the normal force is going to be, because we already know to say that. So compute this on the calculator to say that 10 times 9.8 minus 40 sine 30. We are going to get the normal force over 78.0 newton, because the normal force is measured in newtons. So this is how simple you can handle this kind of equation step by step. So if you find the video help, consider subscribing to the channel. You like the video, you also hit the notification button so that you may not miss out on your uploaded videos. So thank you for watching. Now before we end this video, I would like to let you know that we offer tuition is in whole heinous courses, starting from chemistry, biology, mathematics and physics. So if you need help, if you actually need to clear NS without any struggle, kindly inbox me on this number 077. Where am I going to write the number? Okay, I can write it here 077-6369-666. WhatsApp me on this number so that you may register at just an affordable price of 60 kwacha per course, so that you may be able to access all our subject tutorials, tutorial sheets, past papers and conceptual videos which are made simple for your understanding. So thank you for watching. See you in the next video.